So I'd like to show you a few examples now which come from previous exams. And first thing is I'll note what are the information that's provided in the exams. There's always some course notes which are provided. And in this case, it would be, for instance, for MPSK, there would be a form of the receiver. So you would see there were two branches. And then there would be our calculation that we made for PSK for the probability of error. And so as a function of M, you see this probability of error. So you know the form of the receiver and that. And we do that also for other modulation formats. For instance, for FSK, in this case, there are M branches because you need one branch for each one of the symbols. And the performance is given by this expression for FSK. And finally, for QAM, this is the receiver for QAM. Again, just two branches. However, we don't have a general expression for any QAM because there's so many different geometries we can use in this two-dimensional space where we modulate both the amplitude and the phase. So we did find for the rectangular case for M, which is a square, we found an expression. But in the general case, we have to rely back on this Union-Brown expression. And so the examples I'm going to show you now are really when you're forced to use this general case in order to find the performance of a QAM geometry, which we have not necessarily seen before. So here is an example. It's different from the one I showed you in the last video. Here again, and this is IQ coordinates, I have plus and minus one here for this sort of interior, which looks like QPSK. Previously, this was three. So if one, minus one, you jump two to one, you jump two to get to three. This one is a little bit closer there. You see, it's actually one plus, is it one minus or one plus? Sorry, it's a little even harder for me to see here. I think it's one minus. So one minus the square root of three. That makes no sense. It's got to be one plus the square root of three. So it's one plus the square root of three. And in that case, the distances, you know, I said which is the minimal distance, it would be a different calculation. But once again, it's a lot easier to make that determination about whether the, you know, the minimal distance is between these two or is it these two. Is a lot easier to do the trigonometry in these coordinates, which were chosen to be simple. And I think you won't be surprised to learn that, in fact, these two distances are equal. And, you know, that's why you have this weird factor of plus the square root of 3 over there. So, so in the question, in the exam is, here is 8 QAM. It's 8 QAM because there's 8 symbols here, and it's in a two-dimensional plane, so we're modifying the amplitude and the phase. So that's what we call QAM. Of course, they're not equidistant from the origin, so it is not equal energy. QAM seldom is. And you'll be asked for the coordinates in signal space. So here are the coordinates in IQ space. But we want to do the normalization to put it into a signal space. And the second part of the question is to find a probability of error using the union bound. Of course, to do that, you need to do step A. So step A sort of breaks out what you need to do as an intermediate step to get to B. And then the last part is asymptotically, does it have better probability of error than, and I'll show you what the question was. But first you put it into signal space. Then you can find dmin, and with dmin you can get a probability of error. And now you want to compare this with the performance of another modulation format, and for that you usually compare it to QPSK. And so that would be when you get small dmin, the normalized value. So this question is testing your ability to do these different steps for an arbitrary QAM modulation constellation. So the first step is to take the coordinates in signal space and to convert it to, in IQ space, to convert it to signal space. And first thing I notice is that there's a little error that got in here somewhere. I need this square root of 3. So we'll just pretend that that's there, square root of 3. So I have to go from the coordinates in IQ space, I have to generate the coordinates in signal space. And I have a nice equation that I need to do that. And the most difficult part of that equation is calculating this sum. So to do that, I have to take the constellation, and I have to take the coordinates of each constellation, take the square of each coordinate, and sum them up. And I have to do this for each one of the symbols. Now, I start with the four that are in the closest to the origin, and they're all at the same distance from the origin. The coordinates are plus and minus 1. So I have four points that are the same distance from the origin, and this distance squared from the origin, I can calculate easily is equal to 2. So if I wanted to do a subtotal, I would get 8 here for that subtotal. Now there are four more points, this is 8 QAM, and the other four points are also equidistant from the origin. And there are 0, and then coordinates are plus or minus 1 plus the square root of 3, or minus 1 minus the square root of 3, and 0. And so it's easy to calculate the distance squared to the origin using these coordinates. It's just 1 plus the square root of 3 squared. And so I get 4 plus 2 times the square root of 3 as the square distance from the origin. There are four of them, so I multiply them together. Now I have these two subtotals. I combine them, and I get a number for this total squared distance from the origin when I total them across all of the 8 points. And that comes to 24 plus 8 times square root of 3, or using a calculator, comes to 37.86. So now, with this number, I can go and use the equation that tells me how to normalize these coordinates into the coordinates in signal space. So our equation says that if we want to get the new coordinates in signal space, so these are the signal space coordinates, we get them from the IQ coordinates, which are over here. And I need this factor, which is M. This 8 here is M, the number of points in the constellation. And we have ES, that represents the average symbol energy. And of course, that number we just calculated is what goes in the denominator of this expression. So we end up getting, in this case, I can see there's a factor of 8 everywhere, so I simplify it to the square root of ES over 3 plus the square root of 3. And then I take my calculator out and I say, what is 3 plus the square root of 3? And that comes to 4.73. So I have my normalization factor to go from signals, from IQ space into signal space. I have to take whatever the old coordinates were and multiply them by the square root of ES divided by the square root of 4.73. So in this case, now I need to find the daemin, and I can find the daemin using these new coordinates. And the way I got the, got the coordinates is because you recall I had these three points, which were equidistant, and these had coordinates of minus 1 and 1 in the IQ space. So the distance between these is 2, and if you do the math with the 1 plus the square root of 3, you would see that the distance here is also equal to 2 in IQ space. So if it's 2 in IQ space, that means that in signal space it would be 2 times this normalization factor. So that's why I know that the capital D min is equal to 2 times the normalization factor. So the next step in getting the estimate of the probability of error from the union bound is to find the factor k, which is the number of pairs of symbols which are located at the minimal distance. And so if I look at these 8 points, I know that these 3 points are equidistant, 2 in the IQ space, and you know, by the symmetry of this constellation, I can see that there are 3 more sets of 3 points at this minimal distance. Of course, this point and this point is not at the minimal distance. They're a lot farther apart. So if I count them, I get that there are indeed 12 pairs at the minimum distance. So now I can say for this 8 QAM constellation that the probability of error is equal to 2 times k in this case 12, divided by m, in this case there are 8 points, and I need the dmin times 2 eb over n0. And so I go back a couple steps, and I have my dmin over here, and I can, I should take the dmin, plug it in, and I will get this expression, but I have already converted it to eb over n0 instead of es over n0, so I sort of skipped a step there. The important thing is that we see that there is the multiplicative factor of 3, and now we can isolate the eb over n0, and we can see that the factor that multiplies it is 1.27, and this is another way of saying that that is our lowercase dmin squared for this constellation. So we have found the capital dmin, and we found the normalized one, and we found the normalized one by converting from ES to EB, and then isolating the factor that multiplies EB over N0. The last part of it actually asks, how does this one compare to this constellation? So here is a rectangular constellation from QAM. So you would have to go through really this problem again. So you have to do everything that we did in A and B, you would do again for this constellation. And then you would get a loss compared to QPSK for this one, a loss compared to QPSK for this one, and you see relative to one another which has better probability of error. So the, whichever one of these two had less loss compared to QPSK would be the better constellation between the two. So here's another example, and I won't go through the development here. You can look in some of the old exams. There's lots and lots of examples of different QAM constellations and how to find the minimum distance. And they're always given IQ coordinates and asking you to convert them into signal space coordinates and then to go on to the various steps. And in this case, you can see we have nice round numbers. 1, 3, and 5 for this constellation. You'll see that, you know, like having this QPSK in the center is quite common because often these constellations that we look at, they will have the option that when signal quality is poor, that they will reduce the constellation, and if the signal quality is very poor, they'll end up just reserving these 4 points and the other ones will disappear.